Everyone, I'm going to use SAP2000 again to demonstrate how to design a steel frame. So in this part of the video, I'm going to use the same frame that we've been doing in the first two part of the video series. So what I'm going to do now is to open up my file. Right, so this is the two-story frame that we've been using in the first part, analysis, the second part, RC frame, and in this third part, we're going to design this frame using steel sections, the British steel sections. So first of all, I'm going to let you know something about the steel sections. Right, so these are standard British steel sections that in Hong Kong we're also using it. There are a few common types. The first type we most commonly use is the UB section, or the so-called universal beam sections. There are different sizes, starting from the smallest one. So this is the smallest one. And the first number actually tells you the depth of the section, the depth of the beam. This is the I beam. The second number, 76, tells you the width of the section, that's capital B. And the third number, 13, tells you the weight, which is 13 kilogram per meter of the beam. So this is the smallest British steel section for the UB section, and it goes up to the relatively more larger one. Right, so all these are put in under this catalog, and there are also the second commonly used is the UC section, which you can also find it here, the UC section, the universal column sections, which are commonly used for steel columns. Again, each section is labeled with three numbers representing the depth, the width, and the weight. So again, there are different sizes which you can choose from this table. Okay, so these are the British section that we're going to use for our frame. So what we need to do is based on the same frame. So you're probably familiar with this frame. So what we need to do is we keep the same load, we keep the same load cases, and we keep the same load combinations. The only thing that we need to change is the material. We're not going to use concrete, and the steel sections. So first of all, we go to Define, Material. So here we're going to add the new material. We're going to use this British material. So the region we choose Europe, and under this Europe catalog there are different gray. You can see the word gray here. If you push this pull down menu, you can see there are four different grays you can choose. So usually we choose 275, S275, and that is actually the U strength of the steel, and then you press OK. Right, so S275 is the material or the steel grade that we're going to use for our beams and columns. And then the next thing is we're going to define the frame sections or the section properties. So we go to frame sections, we're going to import new property. We're going to import the steel British steel sections. So you just press this one, and the section is I section. So here, if you go down the list, you can find this BSS shapes, which is the British steel sections. So you choose this. And then on the right, you can see, first of all, you change the material. So we're not going to use, we're going to use the material we just defined as 275, and then on the right we are going to choose all the UB section. So UB, you starting from the smallest one, and then you try to select all UB sections, pressing shift and then left click your mouse. So choose all UB section, right? So you can see on the left here in this box, you can find all the UB sections, the British Steel universal beam sections are imported right into this frame properties. And then we also want to import the UC, the universal column section. So what we do is import new property again. UC section is also I section. So we go down the list, try to find the UC section, right, the smallest one, and then select all UC section, press shift and left click your mouse. Material, make sure you change it to S275. Okay, right. So in this box you can now, you should be able to find, you have UB and also UC sections imported. Right, now we're going to define then two new property. So we add new property. So what we're going to do is you ask SAP2000 to select from all the UB sections the most appropriate ones to suit your frame, to suit the loading. Okay, so what you need to do is in this box you can find the auto select list. What it means is you ask the SAP2000 to automatically select from the list the most appropriate cross-section for your beam or column. So we select auto select list. So first of all, give this auto section name a name, whatever name you like. Let's say this is called beam, because we're going to ask SAP2000 to select all the UB section. So you select all the UB section and then press this add button so that they all comes to the right box, auto selection. So what that means is the SAP2000 will select from these auto selection UB section the most appropriate ones for your beam. Okay, and in the selection process we would like SAP2000 to start with the smallest one. So if the smallest one is not appropriate, then SAP2000 will go for the next one, right, until the program find the most appropriate one. So we try to start with the smallest one, so we select this UB127x76x13, this is the smallest UB section, and then press this button override, select this UB127x76x13. Okay, and you can see this thing here, this is my starting section, and then press OK. Okay, so you can find this beam here. Now we're going to do the same thing for column. So we add new property, auto selection list. Now we're going to define a name or give it a name called column. So we're going to select all the UC section. And add this to the auto selection list. So I repeat, the program will select from this auto selection list the most appropriate cross section for your column. Okay, and in the selection process we we would like the SAP2000 to start with the smallest UC section. So we choose this one, UC152, that's the smallest one. Press override. Select again UC152, 152 times 23. Okay. So you can see here the starting section. So what the program will do is they start with this smaller section for your column. If they find that this small section is not appropriate or is not strong enough, they will find the next one until they find the most appropriate one. So you press OK. So on the box here you can find my beam auto selection list and my column auto selection list. Okay. Now, as I said before, we're not going to change the load. We keep the same load. We keep the same load cases. And we also keep the same load combination. Bear in mind, combination 4 is our enveloped combination, which we're going to use this for our design. Right, so the next thing we need to do is select those two beams, and then we are going to assign frame section, beam, the first one. So what we are trying to do is ask the program to select from this auto beam selection list the most appropriate cross section for these two beams. Okay, so you press OK. Now do the same thing for the columns. So you select column, 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 four columns. Do it again, assign frame sections. This time choose the column auto selection list, right? This one. Okay. Now, so what you're seeing on the screen is these two beams starts with the smallest UB section. Those four columns start with the smallest column section. So then we are going to analyze it first. So go to analyze, run analysis, the same three load cases. Run now. Right, so it's done. So on the screen you can see the deflected or deformed shape under the dead load case. If you want to see the deformed shape for other load cases, you can do that just like what we did before. Show deformed shape, let's say the envelope combination 3. Right, that's the deform shape under low comp 3. If you want to see the bending moment and shear force, let's say the bending moment 3-3. For combination 4, combination 4 is the envelope. So let's look at the bending moment envelope. Right, that's the bending moment envelope. And then we should now proceed to the design. So we're designing the steel frame. First of all, we select the first one, view or revise preference. We are not going to use the American code, we're going to select the British code. So on the first one, you change it to BS British Standard 5950. And then press OK. And then go to the select design combinations, select design combos, combination for the envelope, right? Remember the envelope, right? So this is our design law combination based on the envelope. And then here you uncheck this because we're not going to generate other law combinations. And then you press OK. Now go to design again and ask it the program to start designing the structure. Done, finish. Okay, so you can see what you have finally based on the loading combination for the top steel beam, the top beam, the top floor beam. The SAP2000 select this section for you. UB838x292x176. If you want to know the section properties, how big is that section, you can look at the list again. Okay, so 83 something, right? That's the section that the program finally choose. So it's about 800 millimeters deep, about 300 millimeters wide, right? So that's the section that SAP2000 choose for the top floor beam. And for the lower, the first floor beam, it's even larger, 914, so it's about 900 millimeters, almost 1 meter deep, 300 millimeters wide, and that's the weight. And what about those two? For the columns, all the four columns are UC section 356, 368 times 129, so same section for the top two columns. And for the bottom two columns is a bit larger because the weight, you can see, is 202, not 129. Although the first two numbers are the same, meaning the cross section is the same, but the weight is heavier for the bottom two story, for the bottom two columns. Okay, so that makes sense. Of course, the bottom two columns support more loading, so they need bigger sections. So from this, the SAP2000 finish your steel design, and based on these data, you should be able to sketch on a piece of paper what section you're going to use for those beams and columns. And I will also let you know what connections you're going to use for between the beam and column. Okay?